Everything new in Kapwing broadcasts directly to you, the creator. This is your Kapwing Direct.
Hey everyone, this is Grace from Kapwing, and in the past few months, our team has been working hard to improve your editing experience in Kapwing. And we're excited to say that with the new features launched, you'll have much more freedom with timing out layers, editing audio, making effects like zoom jump cuts, adding outro animations, exporting different file types, and much more. In this video, I'll be your tour guide and show you what features are new in the studio and how exactly you can use them. We are always looking to improve Kapwing, and we need your help in doing that. So after you've had some time to test out the features, leave us some feedback back in the comments below saying what you liked, what you didn't like, what you want to see in the future. Now click the first link in the description to get to Kapwing and let's go try these features out together. So the first update I'm going to go over is the timeline layout. This is probably the most visible change that you'll see as a creator in the Kapwing studio because we've moved the timeline into the actual canvas area. So the timeline will appear if your project has duration. For example, if you upload a video file or if you upload an image and then add duration to that image to make it a video. So this is what the timeline looks like now. You can move it up or down to increase the view space for the timeline versus the canvas, and you can zoom in or out for finer adjustments with the timeline. You can also just completely X this out to find the preview bar down here again and always find it again just by clicking timeline here. Having the timeline in this space is super useful, and I haven't seen many other video editors have the capability to do this where you can basically adjust the timing of different layers in the timeline, adjust where they are appearing in the video and how long they last, while also just adjusting by clicking and dragging on the canvas itself to determine where these elements are and adjusting their appearance on the side with these options here too. Being able to move between all these functions really easily, I find super useful because I'm constantly switching between adjusting these three things: the timing, the appearance on the canvas, and where it is on the canvas. So having the timeline here makes the process more efficient. There's also a lot of flexibility and customizability with the timeline. You can move these layers to wherever you want, different levels if you want them, whatever works for your own workflow. And you can also now insert clips into different gaps, that even if the gap is smaller than the actual clip. And this was something that Kapwing wasn't able to do before. So for example, if I want to move this layer into this gap here, the whole timeline will move down, so I can do that. To trim clips really easily, you can just click the ends of them and drag them down and zoom in for more finer adjustments. You can also easily remove gaps by just clicking the gap and hitting delete on your keyboard. Another update to the timeline experience is that we've added a shortcut for splitting clips. Splitting clips is one of the most frequent tasks you'll do when editing videos, so obviously we want to make this as easy as possible for you. To split a clip now, you can just click the layer you want to split, drag the cursor to that point in the video, and then hit S on your keyboard, and it will immediately split that clip. And of course, you can always still use this split button here to do the same thing, but this split shortcut with the S key just makes it a lot quicker. Another new feature is ripple delete, which makes the process of deleting a clip and deleting the gap that it leaves behind much easier and more efficient. To find ripple delete, you can just right click on the clip you want to delete and the button will be here. And it also has a shortcut that you can press on your keyboard to do this quicker. So if I click ripple delete here, it's gonna delete this whole clip that is selected and then also delete the gap that it leaves behind. And there we go. Without ripple delete, you'd essentially have to click the clip, click delete, then click the gap and click delete, which is like a four-step process that is condensed into that one ripple delete button. Detaching audio is another feature that makes editing audio much easier in Kapwing. A lot of people detach audio so that they can do things like voiceovers or other overlays and change the visuals and audio separately. And you'll find that button also in the drop-down menu if you right-click on the clip and then click the detach audio there, and it will create the audio file that is separate from the video file. So now I can move these video files and audio files wherever I want in the timeline and trim them by dragging the ends as needed. You can also adjust the volume of the audio clip as needed on the right side here using the slider, or you can even just mute it by clicking the volume button all the way down. So for example, I added this image to the end of the video. So after my clip where I'm talking here, there will be that image that pops up while the audio is still playing in the background. Another new feature that's pretty cool is the zoom slider, and this is useful for zooming into videos or zooming out of videos or just clips of videos, which is a super common editing technique, especially for YouTube videos. If you look at most of the popular YouTubers, you'll see constant jumping in and out of clips to provide some visual variation or emphasis on certain parts. I know making one of these zoom jump cuts in iMovie is a process that can take multiple clicks, like as many as 10 clicks, but we have reduced this down to just a few clicks for you in Kapwing. So to use the zoom slider, click a clip, select it, and the slider should be on one of the options on the right side in this menu here. Then you can zoom in or out. So looking back at this previous clip and the transition to that more zoomed in part, this is what it looks like. So you can see that it's just a subtle zoom in, but something like that can add a lot of texture to your videos and make it more entertaining than just having one single shot. If you choose to zoom out, you also have this extra space where you can add context or other images or things around the borders. So that was just using the zoom slider to zoom in or out, but if you want to make the zoom jump cut specifically, where you only are zoomed in for a moment or zoomed out for a moment, you basically want to isolate the part you want zoomed in by splitting the full clip into just that part of the clip. I'm gonna click here, use the split shortcut on my keyboard to split this down to just this clip in the middle. So I just want that clip right there that I've selected, and I'm gonna zoom it in. Then when we watch this back, it zoomed in and then back to the regular frame. We've also updated how adding audio works in general. So now when you click to upload an audio track from your files, the audio track is added to just that scene. So you can see that here, this is the audio track I just imported. If I go to the next scene, that audio track is not there. This is what we call scene-based audio. And if you add audio in this top bar too, that will also just be in the one scene, as you can see here. So if you want to add audio to the full project, at which we call global audio, you can still do that by going to the scenes tab up here and then clicking this plus add audio button. Adding the audio in this way will add it to the whole project. Many people have been looking forward to this next update. We had added intro animations and transitions a while back, and now we have outro animations for you all. These outro animations are a way for your clips to exit the screen, and you can apply them to image and video layers. To find them, just click the clip you want to add the outro to, then go to the animate tab in the right corner, and then you'll have a bunch of animations here. As usual, click one and you'll see that you can apply it to the intro, the outro, or both. And if you click outro, it'll show you what it looks like when the clip is leaving. You can try out different outro animations by clicking around and see what they look like, but they're all essentially the opposite of the intro animations. For example, I'm gonna add the slide effect to both the intro and the outro, and this is what it looks like. Intro and then outro. And then obviously you have the option to change the speed as well. And then the last update I'll be going over in this video is the export options that are now available in Studio. Editing videos means that you're working with many different file types, from video MP4 files to audio MP3 files and images and GIFs. So to make working between all these file types easier, we have added these options to the export menu in Studio. So to access the menu, go to the top caret next to the red export button and click it, and you'll see that you can export as MP4, GIF, image, or MP3. So for example, if I wanted to save this whole project just as an image, I would be taking to this window where I can select the frame I want to take from the video and then click export image, and it will only save that image. Versus if I wanted to save just the audio from a video, I could click export as MP3 and then export only the audio. Having all these options at your fingertips will make converting between all these different file types easier. So for example, just making a YouTube video, maybe you want to turn a video into just an audio track that you can add to your video, or take an image as the thumbnail from your video. So this will make it easier. Thanks for watching this video. If it was helpful, please give it a like and make sure to subscribe so you can stay up to date with all of Kapwing's new features. Let us know what you think of these updates in the comments below, along with any other questions or feedback you have in general, and we'll see you in the next video.